Hi, for today's teardown, finally, I have one of them. I have been watching these radios on eBay for quite a long time, and they are either quite expensive, or the seller is in England or will not send to France, or something like this. But finally, I got one for less than 20 euros, including shipping, I believe. The Racal RT-449 British Military Transmitter Receiver. British Military because you have a broad arrow here, your NATO stock number, serial number 2404 apparently, some instructions about the buttons, some modifications, the metric and imperial screws logo here, engraved, well, included in the casting of the case. Missing battery unit. A quite rough overall condition. Okay, so it is a nice, super compact and portable British military radio. Here the plug to your headset. Main control button. Control here and apparently here the battery, excuse me, antenna socket. Okay, so really, really nice. I am interested to see what we will have inside because my previous Racal radio teardown did reveal a number of soldered modules which were a pain to open. Luckily enough, if you remember, I had two of these radios and I was able to scrap one completely to reveal the contents of the modules. But here I have only one, but this one being is already almost scrap condition. It is not too much a big deal. Some additional information written here. A number of screws on this cover, and we will immediately find out what we can expect. So, spoiler, I did already have a look inside here, and I will already remove some solder. So, cover with seal, aluminium, nothing special. So, here is what we have. A number of modules with each one has his number, but you can see we have 5, 6, 4, 10, so maybe number module number 1 is the board at the bottom or something like this, with apparently holes here for some kind of extractor tools. So I am not, it is all bent here out of the way for each one of the modules. So I am not sure if it is like this by design or it is because the modules were already pulled a number of times. Okay, so they are made to be pulled out, so let's do it. I do not have a proper extractor tool, so I will use a screwdriver. Well, try to. Or two screwdrivers, maybe. Like such. Okay, it is coming off. First module. Module number 4. Modification record. The bottom of a module is actually a piece of circuit board with contact pins poking out. Some of them are soldered to the ground plane here. This is apparently the contact to the antenna here. But it is quite weird, where it is not spring-loaded and I am not sure it is making good contact. And you can see at the bottom we have a big circuit board with matching holes. So if any of these pins get slightly out of alignment, we will not be able to reinsert the module. NATO stock number. So the case was you have these little tabs which are bent and soldered. So I did already undo most of the solder. I will try to save most of them, but maybe I will need to cut some. I will see. Is there something else? Yes. Warning, this unit contains barium oxide. We love barium oxide. Okay, we will try to find out where it is actually. So first module. So first I will undo everything. And then we will have a look inside of the modules if I can open them. I believe so, but we will find out. Second module. So do we have actually the name of the modules? Not really. So maybe you can find information online. I will link a new website I will find about this radio. But it is not written what they do here. But you can see each one has a NATO number, serial number, and modification record. So it means, in one way or another, they were able to modify this module. Or maybe the modification is actually just modifying the settings here. Not sure. So next one will come off quite easily, I believe. Okay, same deal, same form factor. No modification here or no outside set adjustment. Well, adjustment you can reach from the outside. We continue with this one, which is not collaborating very well with me. Maybe this one will be easier first. Yes. Still the same thing, exactly. So let me pull out everything out of the way. Some test points. Okay, and the last one is actually not possible to extract because it seems to be part of a wall motherboard here. So let me pull this out of the way. Apparently we have a connector for the internal wiring of the case, which is actually the control button here and the connector for the headset. And it looks like now it is necessary to undo the screws on this side, which is completely loose by the way, to be able to remove the rest of the contents. This thing here is just a briefer hole you can undo to allow air to go in or escape according to the situation. So we have here four Allen screws, metric 2.5. Okay. About these buttons here for controlling the frequency, they are actually quite hard to turn. And megahertz, 100 of kilohertz, and kilohertz. Okay, so it was easier than expected. You can see the buttons remain captive to the case with circlips. Nice construction here. Little bit of insulation here. Diecast aluminum case. Just here the control button for the functions. It is apparently a piece of circuit board that will turn with gold tracks. I will not bother taking it apart. And your connector here. Okay, so here we have the motherboard. Oh, it is interesting to see actually this module here. It is not connected by the same pins system, but it is connected with these little clamps that will go around the female part of the pins. All golden with numbers that are or not matching numbers here. Okay, and this module is secured by a few screws to the board. We have more screws here. So, will I be able to undo it completely? Is it necessary to undo it completely? I do not know. So, actually, I took a photo, so if needed, I will be able to reinstall the wires in the proper location. Not sure the radio is going to be used anytime soon anyways, but still. So here we have three screws that will allow to remove this cover. And okay, actually it is a kind of a stack of boards that will be super annoying to undo, except if I either cut or unsolder these bridges between the boards. I see nice stuff, in particular about an IC here, so what to do? Okay, let's take this thing completely apart. Could not be too terribly difficult. Yes, the numbers are not yes, actually you can see there is lines here indicating the wires. So if you manage to keep the wires in the same order, they are here actually, you will be able to find out where to connect them. Quite nice. I was not expecting this. So let's undo this module because it is really annoying when it is attached to the board here. Actually, this little unit is more tedious to take apart than expected. It is not because it is small that it is easy to deal with. Okay. Oops. I believe a screw will fall here somewhere. I will check. Okay. So it is better, but still no access to the boards to check out what we have. So I believe further disassembly will be required. First undo here these screws in red that should allow to access, well, to remove this plate at least. There is apparently a few nice components here, so I want to be able to check them, but okay. So quite regular stuff. Here at this level at least, the same washers you had, well, wafer switches you had in the other radio. A stack of plates here like this. And. I see a big circuit, integrated circuit here. It is annoying this thing because it requires complete disassembly. This is already loose by the way. Okay. This is loose. I need to undo two tiny screws here. And can I pull the wires here through the holes? I will try not to undo this plate because it will be too much work to put back together, but I want to check what we have in here. So screws are undone. What remains is actually quite sad, but when it is necessary, I could try to remove the solder, but I believe it will be quite difficult. So instead, I will cut here, flush these things, as anyways the radio is not going to be reused, and I can always solder them later. Maybe actually if I do not cut flush it will be easier. Okay, and here we have just three of them, so it is exactly the same stuff you had in the other Racal radio. Quite painful. Okay, so this board is loose, revealing. Interesting. Plastic IC here from RCA, CD4047, one from Texas Instruments in ceramic, LM205 and MC1596 from Motorola, and look at this, two nice crystals in a glass case. Really, really beautiful. Okay. Then, what else? We are left with another layer here with what seems to be an interesting IC, so maybe I can try to undo the thing like such. And if I just cut the three or five connections here, yes, bend the thing out of the way like such to be able to check this gold ceramic IC. BCC021, dead code of 8706. No brand except for the H letter, so is it Aris? Not sure. But beautiful IC. Probably very obscure. Must be something completely analog. And I did just notice, what do you notice? Look closely on this board. We have surface mount parts. Little capacitors here, and here I see a diode or transistor, and here also little surface mount parts. So really, really nice. We'll notice how the crystals are secured here. Okay, so beautiful stuff already, and we know what to expect in the other modules. So we'll try to reinstall more or less this one, and then we will open the little modules. Wow, believe me or not, it was not easy to put back together. I hope I got the wires in the correct order. I will check before I reassemble the radio with the photo. But for now, time to deal with the modules. So for each one, I will need to unglue the cover tabs with pliers or blade or something, because they're still secured by solder. It will not be easy like such. You get the idea. The goal is to be able to more or less reinstall at least some of them in order to be able to reinstall the cover. So I will deal with it and will be able to check what we have in the modules. So first one, are you ready? It seems these covers are made of tinned copper, so at least it has some value. Like such. What do we have here? Okay, so the other Racal radio I took apart had beautiful ceramic gold ices. These ones, apparently, we have here at least ceramic ices with surface mount design, old school surface mount design, crystal oscillator here with three legs and gold base, and this filter module by Cathodeon England, very nice, all shielded. Okay, it still does not say what is doing this module, but you can see it is beautiful, really. So the pins are really easy to bend out of the way. So I will probably reinstall them on the motherboard before I reinstall the motherboard in the radio, I guess. Could be easier. Okay, so first one, nice surface mount ICs at least. So I still did not decide what I will do actually with this radio. Will I keep it in my collection or will I scrap it? No decisions taken so far. I will obviously not bother re-soldering the covers here, it is not necessary. Okay, so it was the first one. Let's continue. Second one. The pins are bent out of the way, even if I did not really touch them. I am quite careful, but still. So, at least. Rear side nothing, but here you can see at least one beautiful gold ceramic IC surface mount by LTEC L144BL. I am not sure you will find anything on the web about this part. Surface mount, you can see most of the things. Harris probably up amp here. Oh, little bit out of the frame, but really, really nice stuff. It is a shame for these pins here, really. Okay, we continue with module number 9. Here we are. This time we have L144BP with gold legs ceramic cover. Another manufacturer logo here. Two regular CD series clips here, nothing special. Gold pins as always. Okay. So some nice weird capacitor here. You can see a black case, and it was filled from the side and sealed with epoxy from the side. Not something you see every day, and one leg is poking out through this epoxy. Interesting. Actually, the other ones here are the same, the smaller ones. Okay, so at least we have again one nice IC in here. Beautiful IC. So I know if I decide not to keep this radio and retrieve the parts, at least I will have some beautiful parts. Next one. Okay, here we have two boards in this one. Mostly resistors, inductors. They are two times the same thing. So maybe one is for receive and one is for transmit. Surface mount capacitors. Nothing particular except maybe this diode here with gold legs, for probably some kind of detector diode, something like this. Interesting. So nothing super fancy in here. Inside each of the modules you have insulators in mica or something on the sides, and some foam also for shock absorption. Okay. One more module. Ah, this time not very convenient, but also nothing to see, just plastic ICs, three of them. Little vertically mounted resistors, mostly. The same kind of capacitors than previously. You can see nothing in particular in this one, no beautiful IC. Super, super tiny parts. So this one was quickly done. We will conclude this video with this module containing the beryllium. So this one I will crack it open live with you. So the little tabs here are more or less difficult to unglue with the pliers. Not too bad actually, but reinstalling them as they are bent after this operation might be a little bit delicate. Okay, so what do we have in here? Mega zoom this time to reveal the beryllium. Oh. Okay, it is secured here. Well, I will just cut it anyways. Not a big deal. The radio is dead anyways. Okay, so what do we have? Obviously the transmitter side of the radio, because a lot of coils and capacitors, and yes, what seems to be one power transistor mounted here onto this frame. And I can see a white insulator material here, and it's in compound. So the beryllium must be either in here or in the heat sink compound, probably, or maybe inside also the transistor itself. One op amp here. Okay. Regular little capacitors in this yellow or orange coating, or red also. There are actually MLCCs inside. here with lids. Okay, so not much in here, not I was expecting at least a better power transistor, but seems it is nothing very fancy. The legs always bent out of the way, quite annoying. Okay, nothing here. Well, okay, so this will conclude this teardown. Now I have a bunch of modules to try to put back together, more or less, and reinstall all the motherboard. But at least I know I have a few beautiful ICs in this thing. And if I scrap it, gold legs, tin copper, aluminium. It will depend actually if I find another radio of this model in a better condition. I will not keep this one. But for now I will probably keep it unless I find a better one. Not sure. So, thanks for watching. Bye bye.